First today, the death toll from the Sydney nursing home fire has risen to 8 after a 96-year-old woman died in hospital overnight. Police are this morning sifting through bags of evidence seized from a raid at the home of the nurse accused of starting the fatal fire. 10 reporter Andrew Denny is outside the nursing home at Quakers Hill for us this morning. Andrew, just day after day, we're getting more of this bad news.
Yes, sadly, the effects of this fire are still being felt 4 days after the blaze took hold. 96-year-old Doris Beck is the 8th person to die from these fires. She passed away in hospital overnight. And this, of course, follows another death yesterday of Caesar Galea. And if that's not bad enough, 9 more people are in intensive care wards across Sydney. They're elderly, frail and in critical conditions. And authorities are warning the death toll could continue to rise. Yesterday, the nurses who worked here bravely returned to the scene. They laid flowers and said prayers for the sick and the injured. And all of this, of course, is made so much harder for them by the fact that one of their own, a registered nurse, has been charged with murder.
Well, on that murder charge, Andrew, are we learning of any developments from the police in the investigation?
Well, yes, yesterday police searched the home of the man accused of lighting these fires, Roger Dean. They were in there for quite some time, and when they left, they'd seized bags of evidence and a laptop computer. Dean had worked as a nurse at the home for only a few months, and yesterday his employer expressed his utter disbelief at what's alleged to have happened. Let's take a listen.
I don't know if it's surprise, shock. I can't tell you the emotions, and I can't tell you the emotions of all of the people involved in our organisation. All we care about is our residents and their families. And this just goes to our core.
And Ron, with so many people still in hospital, it's important to remember that this tragedy is still far from over. The nurses and the families here will hold a private memorial service out here tomorrow.
Yes, absolute tragedy. Andrew, thank you. Andrew Denny reporting for us live from Quakers Hill in Sydney.